lui un replicante. Questi termini così misteriosi, enigmatici, oscuri.
Well, I will start with the replicants, which are bioengineered synthetic humans that are designed for slave laborers. In the world of their mother, they are like exploration and exploitation of other planets. And most of those planets outside the solar system are worlds that are friendlier. And so humanities, most of the humans that are able to travel through space are invited to and desire to go and live on those planets. And the replicants are there to help them to make those planets a nice place to live. But the thing is that it's like a Frankenstein story. Those replicants sometimes have behaviors problems, and they are illegal. In the first movie, they are illegal, honored, and they are very difficult to spot, but they are very close. What's beautiful about the Rome story is that those creatures, those synthetic humans, are very close to the humans. They mostly share the same experience. But being illegal on Earth, being the special unit squad, it's called Wing Runners, in order to spot them, find them, and retired, which means to kill them, because they are not allowed on the first day.
Che tipo di mondo sarà questo mondo del 2049? Sarà un mondo più oscuro, più inquinato, più digitale?
The thing is that it's a world that will say that that are familiar with the world that was depicted in the first Blade Runner. It was a kind of very beautiful, strong vision, but quite nightmarish vision of our future. And I will say that 2049 is an extension of this idea, and that things didn't went for the best, and that the climate went down, the ecosystems collapsed, and that the characters evolving in this world are surviving in the harsh climate conditions. It's snowing in Los Angeles in the movie, and the ocean rose, and the city had to build a wall to protect itself from the ocean.
So more digital or more analog?
The thing is that, you know, the internet is a very it's not a good thing for our screenwriters. I feel that it's like you're